Welcome to Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. We have 2012 BMW X5 off-road drive 35i N55 auto, and the problem is that we have a issue that the car stalled, and we are tools here. We're using the dealer tools with ICOM Actia. We check the check engine light is on and hard to start, like start and shut off. See, now start, but you see, it's creating trouble. So here we have a couple of quotes, sub counter, disc, and we have a KPS control, too high or too low. Let me try to see if I can read those information first. Frame, all the other code is not a problem, but this is the vehicle information here. We are not communicating with one module, which is luggage compartment lid. It's not communicating. Okay. So let me try to go back again on the management, and we see all these quotes here. So I'm going to try to calculate the test plan. And any code that is, let me put those window up because the guy. See the car start and stall right away. So let me see what I have. Gotta go down. Fuel system, fuel pump. I have code here related to the fuel pump, fuel system. Yeah. So we have this code stored. EKPS control current too high. Is that because of what? This is the information, how does it work, and this is a wiring diagram, the fuel pump control under the fuel pump. Okay, okay. Based on this information that I'm seeing here, brother, I don't want to say the fuel pump. The fuel pump is driven by a special module, a small piece, you call it AKP, electrical or electronic control module, or fuel pole control module. 95% on the back of the trunk, water can get into it, or it go bad. People change the fuel pump and this piece together, but we don't want to go change the fuel pump. If the fuel pump is good, it's better to change this module first and program it. And then in the spot, it will tell us if that the problem or not. But other than that, I don't want to go deep to the fuel pump.
Okay.
So we need to get this part first, the electric fuel pump control module. They call it EKPS, mm-hmm. EKPS, fuel control module.
Mm-hmm.
And then put it in and then you program it. You're supposed to take it good. If it's not, you can change this one. But we need to save money. Instead of changing both of them, mm-hmm. let's start by the module, the small module outside behind the seat.
Okay.
Okay. So we can't get it now. So tomorrow you got it for us. And then we can change it and then we take it from there.
Okay. Can we clear all the codes first and then try to see if it comes back?
That what's going to be happening. That's why I do the recording, that okay. to keep all the information before you clear it.
Definitely.
So
should we run like a full diagnostic or not?
This is a full diagnostic what I did now.
So anything else do you see there?
There's a lot of stuff, but that's not concerning now. Transfer, VTG interface, ultrasonic sensor, because you already have a problem, one bumper broke,
mm-hmm.
Tear indicator light, signal, diagnose module, tank leak.
Yeah, that's not
yeah, that's why I say I don't want to go through all this, just see a lot of stuff.
Clear everything.
Side light, so yeah. Gonna clear all the, you see here, you're gonna see it here, when you see vehicle information, all these are codes.
Mm-hmm.
Anything green is safe, is healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Anything,
should we check the model and try to reconnect it?
Delete, let me see, delete fault memory. Check what?
Should we check the module, like take it off?
No. When they go bad, that module that drives the fuel pump.
Mm-hmm.
The module itself is the one that drives the fuel pump. So when they go bad, sometimes it could be the module itself is messed up. You don't need to change the fuel pump, mm-hmm. just because could be the, or you change both of them together. Why you change something that is working? You got my idea? Right now I have one fault memory. You see now, I clear it.
Mm-hmm.
You see that module I told you? It's still there. Everything go clear. The frame module control and the EKPS itself. If the fuel pump is no good, it will say the fuel pump is no good.
Yeah.
But here it look like, you know, like it's not a fuel pump. The module itself will say, you know what, I am not okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now I have three quotes. Maybe one, two, three. Let me see what I have. Three quotes for sure. You see EKP control, current high.
Mm-hmm.
FRM and no communication with the luggage. So AKPS control current high, that means he cannot see anything. It could be the fuel pump itself is not good, but it could be the supply to automatic luggage side, fuel pump motor current. You know, fuel pump motor current, and the fuel pump motor current is coming from the AKG. I don't want you to go change the fuel pump.
Mm-hmm.
That's the code. EKPS control high current. Possible cause wiring harness,
mm-hmm.
EKPS electronic fuel pump control module. It could be fuel tank, perform troubleshooting and testing. But I feel like.
Can we do it one time and see how it reacts to us?
Which one?
The one you were talking about just now.
Yeah, that's the sensor. But the problem is there already. So I feel like it's better for us to...
Should we diagnose, like clear the code from the
module? I cleared it already. I cleared the code. It's still there in the module. We need to get this module. We need to get it. And if we get it, also we have to program it. It will not start.
Okay.
So we get the module first and then we take it from there.
Okay.
That's my idea.
Okay.
Or if we can leave the car when we... Yeah, that's the best, because either way you have to get them.
Yeah.
Whether the module or the fuel pump. People change the fuel pump and the module together, but I prefer to get the module first.
Yeah.
Okay. So this car, I believe, will go nowhere with you tonight. So we're going to leave it there. We're going to get the module tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow you're going to go by the part department and try to see if you can get one for us.
Okay.
This is only dealer item. So by 63rd and and second avenue where you went before. Then we put it in, we code it, we program it. If respond correctly, okay. If it's not, we drop the gas tank down, we change the gas tank module. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, share, and see you in another video. We're going to give you another video after diagnose and fix this problem.